Hey everyone, welcome to part 3 of our SaaS development series. If you watched the previous part, you saw our struggles with Vault when trying to fix various issues in our GitHub tutorial platform. Today we're switching gears and bringing in Cline, a powerful VS Code extension that I have found particularly effective for complex projects. Instead of showing every single fix, which would take hours, I'll focus on the major transformations that got our app working. We'll tackle three main challenges: getting our build process working properly, fixing our tutorial interface and data handling, transforming the user experience with proper layouts and static data. Let's see how Cline handles the problems that Vault couldn't solve. I will use Cline. I will tell it to analyze the project again. Okay, so it was able to see all of these issues without me having to type it one by one. Okay, let's see if this will now work. Alright, so it's working locally now. You can click on Start Learning. So it compiled pretty quickly here for 21 milliseconds. So we don't need to wait for 20 seconds for it to compile. That's 7 seconds. That's still quite fast. These were able to fix the issue. Pricing 1. Okay, so 1 second. Almost 1 second, only 504 milliseconds. Sign in. Okay, so it works. Let me see if I can change my display name. Something else, AI number 1. Okay, it works. Let me revert it back. So it works as before, but now we have a chance to fix the issue with the npm run build. So now we will ask Cline to fix the issue with npm run build. Then I will ask Cline, maybe let's start with the Firebase folder. Okay, so there's some type issues here again under Firebase. So we're doing the fix one by one. We are repeating the cycle, running npm run build, and if Cline encountered any issues, it will fix it and then run the npm run build again. At least we're getting somewhere. Looks like it worked because we were able to get past the linting and checking validity of types. All right, there you go. The build is successful. This is going to be much faster than the previous build because it's already pre-built. So we can see here that it's working. So now, since our build is fixed, we can try to redeploy our app in Netlify. I'm going to push these changes to the main branch. So far, we are not using any other Git branch. We are using main since we are still working on it in development. Okay, so let's go to the deploys. It's starting up now. This is our latest commit. And looks like our deploy has been successful. Let's open it. There you go. We can try to sign in. Nice. Running in emulator mode. Do not use with production credentials. Let's start a new task. And then okay, sure. We'll go to the slash tutorials right away. And this has been removed. Now we can commit all of these. But as I mentioned earlier, I'm going to create a new branch. I will call this dev. So now we're not in the main branch anymore. We are on the dev branch. So I will commit this. And then I will publish the branch to GitHub. This means that this commit that we have just published or pushed will only live within the dev branch for now until we merge it to the main branch if we're ready to deploy or update our deployment. So right now, the tutorials pages really is not looking good. This is the main issue that we've been trying to solve with Vault earlier. But now let's see if Cline will be able to fix it. I will take a screenshot of this, copy the screenshot, I'll go to Cline and paste it here. because of this component not being used anywhere, client is making some mistake because it assumed that this is being used somehow.
So I will move from generating the tutorials from a database like we are using right now here to a static data. So that means we'll be able to better create interactive tutorials depending on the topic. For example, for branching, this is good. For merging, it would be somewhat different than this. That way, we're free to implement how interactive or how dynamic our tutorial is. So I will now ask client to create a static content under tutorials folder here, maybe tutorials/data something. I will ask client to do that. Okay, so it's not doing what I mentioned to do. Actually, this is a bit dynamic already, but I think we could work on this. My worries are the positioning within the visualization. So it's a bit technical to be able to input this from a non-developer standpoint. If we don't build a dedicated tutorial editor, we won't be able to easily update this. So we want to have a simple solution for this MVP. So I will go with this for now. Then we can fix the topics individually. It's easier to fix the issues this way as a JavaScript object rather than fixing it coming from an external source, which is Firestore. We will still use Firestore for other things like user progress tracking and other things. So we won't be removing that functionality. All right, you can see that made this improvement and there are several steps that was enabled here. But still, there are some issues here that we can fix later. It's important to remove unneeded codes so that it won't interfere with the operation of our AI dev tools. It gets confused because there are files that are existing that's related either by file name or content to the current task, and it's confusing the AI. It confuses everyone actually, not just the AI. For example, if this remains here, then this is one of the things that we can check. But since nothing is using it right now, this is really not necessary anymore. So I will remove the entire services folder so we don't need to be afraid of cleaning up our code base because everything is saved in our Git history as long as we commit on every major changes such as this. Let me commit this and sync the changes to push it on the cloud. This should be on the same paragraph actually, or the same sentence. So these are fine because these are really code blocks. Okay, so I guess we can tell client to look at this. Maybe this is the one causing the issue. I will create a new task. Okay, hopefully client will understand what I mean. It's still the same. We're using React Markdown here. Okay, so I'm just inspecting the code to see if we're fighting, so to speak, the internal functionality of this library component to render Markdown. So this part is the one being rendered by the React Markdown, and it's very simple. You don't need the syntax highlighting there. So it removed tomorrow, it removed syntax highlighter or prism, and it still is showing incorrectly. We definitely need the styles from Tailwind, that is part of the component. However, the code, we are pre-processing it like this, and this closing brackets is coming from the code itself, so we can remove it. Okay, so maybe we can remove this component also. What if we refresh? Do we still have that issue? No more issues. Yeah, I guess this is enough for us. Okay, now let's move on. Let's try to add more tutorial content here. We'll update the index now, yes, to include the new Git remote tutorial. Okay, there it is. Nice. Only the font here is not working well. Let me see what tag it is using. So it's using three tags here. It's using gray. We need to make the text white. All right. The background color. Yes, that's it. Nice. Now we will ask client to resize this simulator. I will start a new task. It just simply updated the height and width. Okay, so maybe we can ask client to enable resizing or zooming. Okay, so it needs to adjust the mouse position calculations. You see, Git Basics, for example, uses some kind of coordinates here. It needs to take into account that calculation. All right, nice. Maybe we can ask client to just simply add some zoom and restore button here. And there we have it. Our GitHub tutorial platform is now fully functional with a smooth user interface. Let's quickly recap what we've accomplished with client. We fixed our build process for successful deployment. We have transformed our tutorial interface from broken to beautiful. Improved performance by migrating to static data. Created a consistent and responsive layout. The complete code for this implementation is available in our GitHub repository. You can find the link in the description below. In the next video, we'll take our application to the next level by implementing Stripe payments. We'll set up subscription plans, handle payment processing, and gate premium content. Make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss it. Thanks for watching. Happy coding.